大家好。吃好了吗？Okay, so good afternoon. Once again, my name is Yuko Tanaka, 田中柚子. I work for Nikkei Business Publications in Japan. Today, I would like to share with you the new phase of development at my company. Let me start with a bit of explanation about Nikkei Business Publications. So, professional, leading edge, and visionary is the tagline of Nikkei Business Publications. As Japan's leading B2B media company that was established in 1969, we have always dedicated ourselves in offering the must-know, leading-edge information for the working professionals. Our information is never a piece of straight news. We delve deep into what is happening now in the industries that we serve, present our own analysis, and shed light on the future directions. Neither are we are just a media company that offers quality information to our audience. We also offer the best marketing services to our client companies, both in and outside of Japan. In other words, we solve the problems and challenges that both our audience and our client companies face today. Nikkei Business Publications started as a magazine publisher. Later on, we started publishing also books, operating websites, hosting seminars and expos, and offering research and consulting services. Today, we publish 40 magazines and 500 books every year. We operate 14 websites. We host 1,000 seminars and expos of different sizes every year. But these are no longer standalone businesses. From the audience perspective, we reach 8 million business people who will choose to read our magazines, our books, our websites on a day-to-day basis, while attending our seminars and expos for face-to-face meeting opportunities with their peers in the industry. When I say 8 million, 8 million is not just any 8 million, because we know who, of which company, living where, and interested in what, is reading our content and taking part in our events. From the client perspective, we offer marketing services that mix and match our media and events for the best outcome for them. So this is the list of our magazines. Our main target sectors are business, technology, and lifestyle, in which we presently publish 38 titles, reaching 2 million subscribers. Although you will see only 38 here, we have actually launched over 110 new magazines and newsletters to date since our inception, while discontinuing close to 70 of them already. So the history of Nikkei Business Publications has always been about offering the best and the most needed information to our audience and to our client companies. And this is the list of the 14 websites that we operate today. Here again, our main target sectors are business, technology, and lifestyle. We started our first website in 1995, and since then have gone through the same process of scrap and build, and now we have just 14. And this year, we made a bold new step with our website, which is one of the two topics that I wanted to share with you today. This past February, we introduced a new website by the name of Nikkei CrossTech. You might wonder why a new website in such a digital era can be a bold new step for a company. I will tell you why. Nikkei CrossTech was a challenge for us for two reasons. Firstly, we brought under the umbrella of Nikkei CrossTech all of our magazines and websites related to IT, manufacturing, and construction. This morning, we heard from Bloomberg about disrupting your own business, That's exactly what we have done too. Prior to the birth of Nikkei Prospect, we had the IT Pro website for the IT professionals, the Nikkei Technology Online website for the engineers in the manufacturing industry, and several websites that offered information on architecture, construction, and home building. All of them have given up their already very strong brands to unite as Nikkei Prospect. The reason was because we saw a trend where the walls that used to divide IT, manufacturing, and construction were starting to disappear. Topics such as AI or IT were no longer a subject of interest just for the IT professionals. Digital innovations were happening across a variety of industry sectors, including manufacturing and construction. The C-suite and other business executives too needed to understand how, for example, RPA and other digital technologies will help reform their business processes. Nikkei Prospect is designed to offer information on the latest technologies that crosses different industry sectors in case studies of business innovations achieved through the adoption of such technologies. At the same time, Nikkei Prospect digs into what is happening at the front line of each industry sector. I believe that only Nikkei Business Publications could have done this because we have 400 in-house journalists who each follow their expertise fields. The second reason why introduction of Nikkei Prospect was a challenge for us. Like many other B2B media websites, our websites were for free of charge to read for our audience, although we did ask for their personal information so that we can make use of such information for our marketing services to our client companies. But given the landslide of advertising money these days, we decided that we should start charging for the quality content that we were offering through our websites. And of course, there are articles that can still be read for free of charge because we still ask our audience to share their personal profiles with us. But there are also articles that are behind our paywall and can only be read by those who pay an annual subscription fee of $270 per year. This might not sound much, but it is if you were not paying anything and all of a sudden you have to start paying for the content that you were reading. Presently, there are over 20,000 people who pay this money, and the number is increasing. This past April, we took the same strategy for our marketing portfolio of magazines and websites under the new brand of Nikkei Cross Trend, which is also going very well. I would also like to introduce another digital challenge of Nikkei Business Publications, which we call the joint media. Joint means that we are making use of our ability to create quality content and produce websites on behalf of our client companies. The concept is similar to what is called the owned media, but slightly different. These are a few of the joint media that we have produced. What is different from owned media is that the names of the sponsoring companies do not appear at all on the websites. For example, Panasonic is one of such hidden sponsors, and their objective is not to promote their own products, but to unveil how advanced consumer electronic products will actually change the future of our lives and the society. Asahi Breweries, which is one of the bigger beer makers in Japan, is another such sponsor, and their objective is not to sell beer, but to convey the joy and fun of drinking to the younger generation who don't really drink as much as we used to. There is another sponsoring company who wishes not to be named at all, but their objective is to promote the mega solar industry in both Japanese and English languages. Currently, there are about 10 of such joint media projects, all of which are very popular, and the sponsors want to continue keep funding them, although their names do not appear at all. away from digital. Nikkei Business Publications, as I mentioned earlier, is not just a media company. We are also a solutions provider company. You may have heard about the Economist Intelligence Unit within the Economist Group. The EIU are the research and analysis division of the Economist Group. Nikkei BP Intelligence Group is the research, analysis, and consulting division of Nikkei Business Publications. We launched this business in 2010, and at that time, it was a very small, local experiment that just a few people in the company thought, well, it might be fun to work on. But its presence has been increasing rapidly in the recent years, achieving 20 to 30% year-on-year growth in terms of revenue. We started from one research institute within the company, the CleanTech Institute, and now we have 9, each focusing on different industry sectors, such as management, marketing, medicine, and communications. There are presently 80 researchers altogether, and they have solved hundreds of challenges that were brought to them by their client companies. Some of the client companies, they wanted advice on how to create a new business or how to advance into markets. Others wanted support on coming up with their company's long-term vision or finding business partners. 90% of such challenges and problems that are brought to us are from the private sector, but even the government and the administrative organs in Japan, they come to us for advice. The output differs from case to case. In some cases, we will produce a report for the client company. In other cases, we will host events or create websites for the client company. We also hold workshops to bring together competitors in the same industry to work together for the sake of that industry. We also publish big books that cost very expensive that foresee the coming future in the range of like 30 to 50 years. There are other research institutes in Japan, such as the Mitsubishi Research Institute, or the Nomura Research Institute, or the Japanese arms of Boston Consulting Group, or McKinsey and Company. But what makes us different from the others? Because of the magazines and websites that we have, there are many in the company who have experienced the chief editor post. As chief editor, they know the industry inside out, and they have very strong networks, particularly with the top management level people. And even after they leave the post of the chief editor, people remember them, and they keep coming to them for advice. And this is how Nikkei BP Intelligence Group works, and this is our strength and what makes us different from the others. So when you see this workflow, you might think, oh, this is the workflow for producing a magazine or a website article. It is, but at the same time, this workflow is also for our research and consulting services. When a project is brought to us, we start from quantitative and qualitative research. We then go out, meet people to conduct interviews and analyze the information that has been gathered to build a strategy. We then communicate that strategy and verify the outcome. Our research is not desktop research. It's real-life research that can be done because of our background as a media company. Also, our reports are written in ways, it's not boring, it's written in ways that are fun to read, also because of our capability as a media company. The research and consulting business is a long-term project that would sometimes require maybe 1 year, 2 years for a proposal to turn into real money. However, profitability rate is very high, and we needed to identify how we can monetize our experience as a media company. We wish to make Nikkei BP Intelligence more global in the future and are looking for partners outside of Japan, especially here in China. So please do let me know if any of you are interested in discussing this with me. So This is the end of my presentation, and I hope there has been some takeaways for you. Thank you.